Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, I have a lot of thoughts and studies running through my head right now, but I'm going to grab this first one right quick and see if I can get through it within a couple of minutes. Now, and this one is in terms of being in agreement or understanding someone when you're in situations with them. And we have to be very careful whether how we acknowledge to them that we agree or we understand, because they're two clearly different paths. When someone is on a tangent, so to speak, and they're talking or they're searching for something, you have to be very careful with how you address your response. If you agree, you agree. If you understand, you understand. But you have to be clear, because individuals have the knack for coming back later on after a situation has passed and approach you with the notion that you were in total agreement with them because you said, "I agree." Now, go with me to Matthew 20. And this is the perfect example about an agreement. And this is why these lessons are in Scripture. Now, this is the Savior speaking, Matthew 20, and it reads, "For the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is an householder, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers into his vineyard." Now, this individual went out. This man, the good man he was referred to, went out to hire individuals to work his vineyard. So, verse 2, "And when he had agreed with the laborers for a penny a day, he sent them into his vineyard." So, these individuals that were there said, "Okay, we'll do it for a penny a day. For a day's work, we'll do it for a penny." Now, mind you, that was a decent amount of money back then. So they agreed to a penny a day. Verse 3, "And he went out about the third hour and saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said unto them, Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right I will give you. And they went their way. And again he went out about the sixth and ninth hour and did likewise. And about the 11th hour he went out and found others standing idle and said unto them, Why stand ye here all day idle? They said unto him, Because no man hath hired us. He said unto them, Go ye also into my vineyard, and whatso is right that ye shall receive, that shall ye receive. So over the course of the day he hired individuals to go work in the vineyard. And he told them, Go, and I'll take care of you later. Whatever is right, I will take care of you. So this went on all day, and then at about the 11th hour, he hired some individuals and sent them to go work. So shortly after that, apparently, the work was done. So verse 8, he says, "So when evening was come, the Lord of the vineyard said unto his steward, Call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning with the last unto the first. And when they come that were hired about the 11th hour, they received every man a penny." So everyone was paid equally a penny. It didn't matter if they started at 5 in the morning or 11 o'clock and they were all finished at noon. So they were all paid a penny. Now, you know how people are, even today. If someone hires a bunch of individuals to do yard work for $10 a piece, and then someone comes at the last hour, and then when they all turn around and get paid, it gives that person that came the last hour $10, you're going to have issue. But this is an example as to what I was telling you about. An agreement is a binding law, and the Father and the Savior illustrates it in the Word. Verse 10, "But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more, and they likewise received every man a penny. And when they had received it, they murmured against the good man of the house, saying, These last have wrought but 1 hour, and thou hast made them equal to us, which have borne the burden of the heat all day. But he answered one of them and said, Friend, I do thee no wrong. Did not thou agree with me for a penny?" So this individual, or the group that started first, they were fine with a penny if they stayed all day and no one else showed up and they worked for a penny and got paid that penny. They would have went away happy. So we see a lot of things being illustrated in this. because someone came later and later and later and received the same pay, they were treated equally. Now, some of what we're being taught in this is that the Father is treating us all the same, whether we come today, 5 years ago, 20 years ago, or tomorrow, or the day after tomorrow. He is going to be the same fair, just Father as He is to all of us. Imagine if we had to do everything at a specific time, or we're not allowed to, according to what He wants us to do. We'd all be in trouble. Everyone is not going to do what they're supposed to do at the same time, but He's telling us and showing us here, but He's going to treat us the same. Now, I'm going to say this for some of you: don't count on a bedside prayer. That was something that was told to me a while back. I heard that and it's always stuck in my head. Don't count on a bedside prayer. Don't get caught up and think that you can live your life and do any and everything you want, and at the last minute, if you're fortunate enough to be on a deathbed, think that you can talk your way into heaven. If you think a last minute prayer is going to get you into heaven, in lieu of a wicked life you've lived, you're really taking a serious risk. I'm not even going to say you're not going to make it. You're taking a serious risk, because as we are told, faith without works is dead. So we can't just accept the Father and believe and think we're going to make it. We can take that chance and think, but here's the difference. The thief on the cross was an example. Now, we don't know how he lived his whole entire life, but we know that at the end, he was accepted. But we can't all run around living that type of life, because here's the difference. We know, and we have always known, about the Word. See, the opportunity for us has been with us our whole life. So we can't ignore the truth. We can't ignore the Word, rebuke the Word, and then at the last minute want to sneak in. See, that's a difference right there. So don't get caught up in thinking that because the thief on the cross was accepted at the last minute that we're going to be accepted. See, we can't ignore the Father our whole life and then at the last minute say, "Oh, Father, I love you. I believe in you. I accept you," and think we're going to make it. Now, I'm not going to say you're not, but I'm not going to take that risk. I know the truth. I know the Word. It's right here in front of me. So I'm going to acknowledge it now, like I always do. I'm going to walk the walk, talk the talk, pray, repent, all the things He requires of us to do. There is a work for us. So, anyway, with all that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2 of 8-7. I'm out.